What is up, my YouTubers? Hello, it's Jennifer, and I'm coming at you with a as I drop my camera. Hi, puppy. Come on, come over here. Let me pause this so I can get him on the bed. Hold on. Okay, so I'm back, and if you haven't seen a lot of my videos, this is Diego. He decided to say hi. Say hi.
Yes.
Anyways, okay, so today's video is my mental health check-in, because if anybody has seen any of my other videos about me and my BPD, my anxiety, legal troubles, pretty much anything that I have ever talked about. I'm like trying to adjust here with my pretty background that I think I'm going to use for now on. Anyways, okay, so what's going on? So, mentally, since my best friend Stephanie came out to Wilmington, I'm doing a lot better in my anxiety, my borderline, my grieving for my daughter. If you haven't seen my video, my daughter actually was killed this past March. She was 16 months old, and that's a different video. Please watch it. It's very emotional. Disclaimer, it doesn't show any like graphics or anything. It's just me being telling my side of the story of how horrific it is, because if anybody has ever lost, you know, anybody, a loved one, you know how tragic and painful it is, especially when it's sudden. So disclaimer, don't watch it if you are going to be crying your eyes out, if it's going to make you whatever. Anyways, so going on. So yeah, basically I'm still not fully angry at the lady. I'm kind of angry about what she still might get or what she still might be facing. I don't know. I guess I've just been working a lot, and due to my DWI, which again is a different video, where I have to do my active days in jail, as of tomorrow is Monday, I go in for my weekends, which it's during the week. I chose Monday and Tuesdays because they are the slowest days at work, and they are, you know, I only do 2 days at a time because, one, I'm done with jail. I'm so over it. So, basically, tomorrow starts 46 days left active that I have, which is a pain in the ass. And some people would be like, oh, why don't you just do the 46 days straight? One, because, one, I need the money. I cannot miss work whatsoever at all. I mean, bills have to get paid. I've already spent enough time in jail. I'm not about to spend 46 days in there straight. No, I'm sorry. Now, towards the end, I'm sorry, my eyes, let me pause this because my eyes are really irritated. I have to go check it. Okay, yeah. Sorry, if my eye looks irritated now, it's because I had something in it. Anyways, so, basically, 46 days left. So, I do them 2 days at a time. There are going to be some holidays, like next week is Labor Day, so I won't be going to jail because they don't usually take weekenders, is what they're called, in jail on holidays. So, that's kind of nice. Unless I was going in on a Sunday, then they would take me, but whatever. I could have done a 24 hours, like on a Tuesday after Labor Day, Monday, Labor Day, but I don't feel like it. I'd rather just take the 2 days off. Anyways, so coming up, I'll have a couple one-dayers because, you know, there's Christmas, there's New Year's Eve, there's my birthday, Halloween, Thanksgiving. Basically, starting tomorrow, I'll get done probably sometime in February, unless there's a hurricane or I get sick or whatever. So that's anxiety ridden. My anxiety is kind of high with that because it's just a pain in the royal flipping ass. And yes, I'm sitting near my curtains, so if you see them blowing, it's because it's a really nice cool night and it's windy out and it's so nice. That is actually exciting. I think summer kind of got me down just because it's just been miserably hot and humid, and just I haven't done anything. My scooter's been broken, so I couldn't like just get up and ride anywhere. It's a pain in the ass. Every time I would want to do anything, Then I feel bad that I'm leaving Diego at home. So it's kind of like, okay, well, fine then. So that's kind of, that's a little depressing. The fact that I'm kind of stuck in the house. On one hand, I like being stuck in the house. On one hand. Because it's kind of nice to just sit and chill. Do my crafts if I want to. Watch YouTube videos. Watch movies. Cook, clean. You know, basically do whatever I want. But it would be nice to get out. So when my friend Stephanie came out, it was so nice. Because I have not been out, like, to do anything at all. I've been doing okay. I've been doing a lot better than I have been. I will put it that way. I'm a little impatient. Because I'm still waiting for Tristan, my daughter's father, to be found. I don't know if I mentioned that in a different video, but we'll mention it here just in case. Basically, what's going to happen is, my lawyers have to find him because he was never in my daughter's life. He has to sign abandonment papers, and then I get, I guess, some type of settlement money, which is annoying because my daughter should not have died to get money. But, I mean, that pisses me off. That, I guess, pisses me off the most. And upsets me the most, because it's like, I'll have enough money possibly to put a down payment on the house so I can have my dream of owning a home with a yard so I can foster and adopt dogs out or animals in general. But it pisses me off royally that she died to get one of my dreams I was working so hard for on my own. But I mean, I won't say I let it go. I've kind of accepted it. Like, okay, there's something good that's coming out of this. And my daughter loved dogs. I mean, like, every time she would see a dog, her first word was doggy. I mean, what child, what baby says two-syllable words as their first word? I guess she did. She said doggy. But yeah, so my emotions are kind of not as up and down anymore on that. I'm not on any medications at all because I was on Strattera, and for some reason this last time I was taking it, it made me have more of the suicidal thoughts or self-harming thoughts, which is really weird because I've only taken it one other time before and it didn't do that before. Zoloft I loved, but it kept making me nauseous after nauseous, way past the date it should have. So my psych said, nope. I was going to therapy, and anybody who's ever seen any of my videos knows how much I just don't like therapy. To me personally, I find it a waste of time. It helps sort of, but honestly, I've already been through, DBT skills and stuff. So I already know all the tools, techniques, etc., etc., to calm my anxiety down, distract myself, do all this stuff. And I don't need an extra person telling me to do it or to talk about my feelings and get things out. It's like, I can do it on my own. Not everybody can. And maybe I'm completely wrong. It's just basically, I didn't go in August. No, I was supposed to go in July, and I skipped the appointment. I can't remember why I skipped the appointment, but doesn't matter. Skipped the appointment. Then I got a text last week that says my therapist is no longer at the place I was going, so I'd have to get a new one anyways if I went back there. So that's kind of discouraging, but I'm waiting for my PO, my probation officer, to basically say, oh, have you gone to therapy or blah, blah, blah. It's like, no. And I tell her, look, I don't want to go. And her solution is, well, I will court order you to make me, or she'll court order me to go to therapy. It's like, for what? You're going to court order me to go to grief counseling? That's bullshit. You can't force somebody to do something. I mean, she's a probation officer. She can do whatever she wants, which don't even get me started on the legal issue with my probation. One hand, I'm like the lowest risk person ever because I don't do anything. I work, I come home, I do my active days in jail, and I mean, I go shopping every once in a while and spend way too much money at Dollar Tree, Wish.com. But I mean, I really don't do anything. So my PO, and I meet all my appointments. I've never missed any. I make sure to call her if I have any issues and text her both. I call the office, I call her work cell phone, and I text her. I do three things to make sure she gets my message if anything happens. And I guess most people don't. But I mean, oh, and this past 24th, yesterday was the 24th, as of yesterday's date, the 24th, I have 26 months left on probation. So I'm basically, to sum up, I'm pissed off that the lawyers have not found Tristan yet to have him sign these abandonment papers where, you know, whatever. That's pissing me off. I'm pissed off because my probation officer court to court ordered me to do grief counseling. But just honestly, I'll just lie and say I've gone. I'm pissed off because I still have to do active jail days. I'm pissed off because I'm still 26 months left. So those are my pissed off emotions. I'm disappointed because pretty much the same thing, but I'm excited. I'm excited, one, because, I mean, let's face it. I mean, out of a tragic death, I am honestly excited that I will get something positive to come out of it. I'm not going to lie and say, oh, you know, I'm not excited. I'm just saying that, you know, but I'm also excited because my jail days are honestly almost over. I have less than 50 days. They will go by fast. My birthday's coming up. I'm doing my jail days during the winter when there's really almost nothing to do. I don't know. It's like, I'm just kind of, you've seen my videos. Anyways, so I'm going to end this video because it's probably long, boring, annoying. Anybody who's seen my videos is probably used to this. So, yay. Okay. By the way, coming up in next year, I'm going to give a preview talk. Okay, basically, I'm changing my way I'm doing my videos in 2020. I'm telling you guys now. Why? Because I just realized how to do all this stuff on YouTube. I'm going to have basically four categories, which I'll discuss later. So that's exciting. That's where I was going with this. That's exciting because I finally realized how to do my YouTube videos better, what software I'm going to buy to edit my videos, and the categories I'm actually going to narrow down to talk about each week. I figured out that, yes, I'm going to keep consistent and upload videos every Sunday. Unless I have an extra video, like I said, that you know, I want to throw in there. So yeah, that's exciting. But yeah, if you guys liked this video, if you found it kind of nice to have me check in emotionally, because my anxiety is a lot lower. I think it's because I go into jail, honestly, and I sleep for 2 days. I mean, Well, let me just say this here. When people who have high anxiety or borderline do not get enough sleep, at least for me personally, I flip out. I mean, it's like PMS on like probably crystal meth. I don't know. I've never done crystal meth, but it'd be like PMS on steroids. Because you're just so, not only is your anxiety heightened, you're just like so agitated. You want to crawl out of your own skin when I lose sleep. But being attacked by my curtains. Totally lost where I was going with that. But I've been sleeping a lot. That's, I guess, what my point is. I've been eating really, really well this past summer. It's been so hot to eat, like, heavy food. So I've been eating a lot of salads. Taking better care of my skin. Just a lot of self-care, I guess, since my friend Stephanie came out. So It's nice. I'm excited to start moving forward, I guess, and stop wallowing in my misery and self-pity and whatever else I've been doing. All right. Well, hopefully you guys will like this video. Click the like below, please. Because we like when you click the like button. We like when you click the share button. Because we want to share, share, share. And we want to subscribe. And we want to pass this video along. Because, like I said in my other one, I want at least 50 subscriber. I can never say the word subscriber. There we go. I want 50, hopefully. Like I said, by September 1st. Well, that's in like a week. So I said October 1st. We'll see. But you guys stay awesome, and I will do another video next week. Bye!